Hey everybody, how's it going?
Today, let's take a detailed look at the all-new 2013 MINI Cooper S Paceman.
And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth review of the Paceman. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip and go over the performance data, and show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior, as well as exterior.
And a special thanks and shout out go out to Hendrick MINI, located in Charlotte, North Carolina, for allowing me to come out and film the 2013 MINI Cooper S Paceman.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run. The exterior color is known as brilliant copper, and this particular one featuring a full carbon black leatherette interior. Upgraded leather surfaces are also available as an extra option. To start, all you have to do is take key fob, put it into the slot, put your foot on the brake, and hit the dash mounted button to go. Very nice. The steering is speed proportional rack and pinion, and a unique three-spoke steering wheel with soft leather that almost wraps around and tucks over, and this little edge coming around the rim. Thick bolsters across the side give a little bit more of a sure-footed grip and a sporty feeling, and a little bit of high-gloss black veneer highlighting around the horn ring. As far as the gearboxes, there's two different options, a six-speed manual, or this particular one, six-speed automatic, with manual shiftability down below here, or via the steering wheel mounted paddle shifters. Accented in leather and chrome with the S badging across the sides into a leather shift boot. Handbrake located in the middle. Unique non-traditional design. So we're going to flip on the automatic headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. Both the windows are fully automatic. And we'll go ahead and check out the exterior, shall we?
It's been just over 10 years since the MINI brand made its big comeback with the reintroduction of the Cooper hatchback, now backed by parent company BMW. Ever since, MINIs have started to show up everywhere, it seems. Their popularity of being small, yet quirky automobiles is a testament of staying true to a traditional layout, but adapting it for a modern age. Over the years, MINI has basically experimented with a wide variety of models that include performance with John Cooper Works, to MINIs for utility, family, and just pure style. You can say that as of now, MINI has been entering just about every segment while creating some of its own unique niche markets. The all-new Cooper Paceman is one of these unique models that is designed to slide in between the standard Cooper hatchback and the larger four-door Countryman that was introduced back in 2011. For some, the hatchback just doesn't have a practical enough back seat for taller passengers, but it offers better performance and a tighter package. The Countryman, on the other hand, is the largest MINI ever produced and can be had with all-wheel drive. It has plenty of room for four with a reasonable trunk. The downside is that it doesn't handle with sharp precision just because of its size, weight, and height. It can be had with the John Cooper Works Performance Group, but the factors previously mentioned limit it from being on the same level as its smaller siblings. This is where the Paceman comes in. It's smaller than the Countryman, eliminates two doors, and rides on the same wheelbase. The styling is more raked and slanted to give it a sportier, racier look. In fact, just about every inch has been restyled to separate the model, except for the front, which for the most part is very Countryman-like. A lot of people actually make the reference that the styling changes make it reminiscent of a MINI Range Rover Evoque, no pun intended. Styling isn't the only thing, though, that sets the Paceman apart. The overall length is around an inch shorter, while as I mentioned the wheelbase is the same, which translates into comparable interior room while it is a little bit less as you'd expect. The roof line is 1.7 inches shorter, which decreases interior headspace by around half an inch. Ride height has also been lowered by 0.4 inches, which gives it the lower stance and lower center of gravity for better handling. Along with more sport-inspired retuned shocks, springs, and steering, it's a nice blend of compromise between practicality and performance. The Paceman also features unique horizontal tail lamps versus the traditional MINI vertical lamps, and now for 2013 features the model designation scripted across the rear hatch in chrome horizontal letters. The 2013 Countryman also has that, and it's very reminiscent to cars of the 1950s and 60s, so it's a little classic touch. There's a wide variety of wheel options available, like these 17-inch Black Star aluminum alloys wrapped in 205/55 Continental all-season tires. Brace consists of four-wheel vented discs measuring 12.1 inches in front and 11 inches in the rear, with single-piston sliding calipers that can bring the Paceman to a stop from 60 miles an hour in as low as 109 feet, which is quite short. The suspension is composed of independent McPherson struts in front and an independent multi-link rear suspension with front and rear anti-roll bars. Overall length is 161.8 inches with a width of 70.4 inches and a height of 59.8 inches. Total curb weight is right around 3,200 pounds.
And we're going to pop the hood.
In the US market, all MINIs come with a standard all-aluminum 1.6 liter dual overhead cam 16-valve 4-cylinder and can be had naturally aspirated or turbocharged. The Cooper S, as we see here, is the turbo variant. Base model cars produce 121 horsepower and 118 pound-feet of torque, while the turbo kicks out 181 horsepower at 5,500 RPM and 177 pound-feet of torque as low as 1,600 RPM. Using the car's sport mode dials up the overboost in the turbo to temporarily increase torque up to 192 pound-feet. This leads to a manufacturer claimed 7.5 seconds to 0 to 60 with an approximate quarter mile time of 16 seconds at 90 miles per hour. Standard cars are front-wheel drive, while all-wheel drive is an option just like the Countryman. And as far as fuel economy, with a 12.4-gallon fuel tank on required premium fuel, expect to see around 26 city, 32 highway. Always one of the cool things about the MINI brand is that they're highly customizable, down to the seat material, color accent piping, styling, trim, electronics, etc. The Paceman's interior, though, is largely derived from the Countryman, features good build quality overall. There's a good amount of soft touch material on all the door panels and key touch points, including a stitched armrest. Overall feels like a tighter package due to its reduced dimensions. Accent lighting found inside the door handles, your lock and unlock, power mirrors are located on the door, as well as your power windows like you saw earlier versus the traditional toggle switch in the center console. This change will also go over to the Countryman. It's a little bit better ergonomics for these particular applications. As far as the seats, they're manually adjustable with manual height adjustment and a nice amount of bolstering down below and up top. They also have a reasonable amount of padding in all the areas, and especially with the cars equipped with manual lumbar. Side airbags all the way around, unique logo door sills, aluminum sport pedals, as well as a manual telescoping steering wheel. The dash is also accented in padded material with high gloss black veneer around a lot of the vents and other controls of the vehicle. All nicely tied off with the optional full panoramic sunroof.
So let's go ahead and see how she sounds.
There is a rev limiter and park in neutral around 4,000 RPM.
and shut her up. Nice soft closing doors. The Paceman comes standard with a premium audio system with an in-dash CD player and standard satellite radio. You can also option out to have a navigation system put in place of the speedometer cluster, as well as a premium, I believe it's the Harman Kardon audio system. But even the standard system packs quite a punch. Don't you cry no more. Side curtain airbags. Side visors for sun. Microphone for your hands-free Bluetooth telephone.
Auto-dimming movie mirror. And in the top stack here, you have controls for your interior illumination, as well as ambient illumination, changing the brightness, as well as changing the colors,
as well as controls for your sunroof. Pop-up wind deflector. The back glass is just fixed with that sunshade.
The entertainment system is very simple to use. Just your simple digital display here with your preset stations, different radio options, changing the sound settings. System configuration, pairing a Bluetooth telephone, as well as activation of the telephone if it was paired. In-dash CD player, high gloss black surrounds coming down the center stack, as well as your simple electronic automatic climate control. With your fan speed, different zones, temperature, one-touch automatic, recycling, front and rear defrost, also in the shape of the Mini Crest. Down below here is your traction control, sport mode. Down below that is a bit of storage, two cup holders, and a 12-volt power outlet, pad center console. It's also adjustable, as well as a little sunglass container. And moving this out of the way, reveals your little iPhone or iPod holder. Strap it in. Your USB and auxiliary inputs are located right below it.
Intermittent wipers, all of your lighting controls, cruise control off to the right, and radio controls, hands-free telephone, and voice commands off to the left. Help.
You can say the following commands. Dial number. Dial name. Save name. Delete name. System off.
All for your hands-free telephone. But in a nutshell, that's all the basic features of the interior. Very unique, simple, and functional. And we're going to check out the back seat. Easiest way to get into the back seat is to flip up on this little handle here and slide the seat forward. Captain's chair fashion. And it's pretty easy to get into the back. Definitely larger than a traditional Mini Cooper, but just a hair smaller than the Countryman, so it's a little bit of a blend between the two. Adjustable sliding cup holders, a rear power outlet, the manual lumbar for the front seats, and side curtain airbags to the rear. All right. And we'll check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we?
The Paceman also features a pretty nice amount of cargo space for a vehicle of this size. Standard luggage capacity is around 11.6 cubic feet, and when you fold down the rear seats, it actually expands to 38.1 cubic feet, so it is pretty practical thanks to the hatchback. There's also some rear illumination, a cargo cover for a little bit of privacy, and if you look down below in the hidden panel, there's also a nice little storage well for some secondary storage.
Same manual adjustments for the passenger side that you find on the driver's.
Good size glove box, also illuminated. You gotta love all the unique air vents as well.
As unique as a lot of the Mini Cooper variants are, they all have their own unique character and special nuances, which definitely keeps the fun the Mini brand always seems to have. Charming automobiles for those looking for something just a little bit different.
Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the all-new 2013 Mini Cooper S Paceman. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.